Every teenager's dream and desire is to enjoy their youthful stage. This was Juru's dream. Unfortunately, for the past 13 years, Juru has battled with pain, splitting headaches, frequent hospital visits, and painkillers because of a rare condition called hemihypertrophy, also called overgrowth syndrome. On a world scale, this health condition happens in about 1 in every 11,000 births. Banks Juru, aged 15, has been challenged as a teenager as her body parts are growing disproportionately. The right side is growing faster, longer, and bigger than the left. Her right limbs are bigger and her chest and stomach are swollen. Additionally, her skin is covered with rash and red patches. This has caused her a lot of pain, stigma, affected her academic performance, not to mention the financial strain on her parents in search for a medical solution. Here is Juru Banks' story. Banks Juru is a Senior 2 student at St. Lawrence Citizens High School Horizon Campus. According to Juru, it has been a long, tough, and painful journey. She recollects the pain starting at the age of 5.
I'm growing up and understanding things. That's when I started noticing that I had a rash on my right hand, and that my stomach, my right side of the stomach was bigger than the left. I got scared, so I went to my mom. I asked my mom what's wrong. She didn't give me an answer because she also didn't know what's happening. So I lived it. I thought it was something very normal. It stayed there and didn't go, but it increases. As I grew up 13, everything becomes clear to me. I now know that I started feeling abnormal because I could go to school and everyone is fine. I'm not always going back home because I'm sick. I'm not always going back home because of health issues. When I look at my hands, they are not of the same size. When I look at my stomach, it's not of the same size. I got scared. So I kept on pressuring my parents, what's wrong with me? We go to the hospital, they do tests. Even doctors themselves get surprised to see something like this.
The disproportionate body parts have caused her to have a lot of stigma, to the extent that she has to wear big clothes to disguise, although it's very hard to cope with.
When I entered high school, secondary, it became more tougher because I went to a boarding school. So I rarely get to be with my parents. So, and the only person who actually understand my pain is my mom, and of which now she's no longer near me. I had to adjust with the environment, but because of my body, I got insecure. Every time I could always be in a sweater, every time I could always wear big, big clothes so that I can cover the abnormality, so that I can prevent questions. Why is your hand hot? Why do you have red marks on your body? Why is one hand longer than the other? Why is your hand look like for a man? The questions they always ask me. Why is your stomach not the same size? So to avoid those questions, because I also don't have the answers to those questions. If they ask me, I go ask my mom. My mom, same thing.
Over the years, Juru has learned to manage the pain. However, she says the pain is spontaneous.
Every time I have pain, I just go somewhere quiet and I cry. I try to bear with the pain. If it's too much, I call them home and they take me home. The same process over and over again. I don't know what to say, but it was hard. It is very hard for a girl like me to cover up abnormality. It's very hard to cope with the pain. It's very hard because the pain is, it's just too much. The point where I can't bear it, it's too much, the point. And of recent, I get headaches, but they come from the back of my head. When the back of my head, then they go down to my neck. So when they come, it's like someone is holding me, it's like I have a stroke. So I can barely move other than cry and shout. But the more I cry also, the more the pain is increasing. So
Juru's mother, Chami Zainab Owera, recalls carrying her pregnancy without any complications. Juru was a normal and healthy baby at birth and brought a lot of joy to her parents. However, the happiness was short-lived after her daughter turned 2 years. Uwera noticed the overgrowth of her daughter's body parts at the age of 4.
I noticed that her hand, one hand of right side, grows bigger and it was longer than the left. That is something that you don't see right away. But when I saw it, it was so strange. We rushed at the hospital. Doctors could not even understand what is the condition. We didn't even have a name of her condition until recently, when the doctor told us that that condition is called hemihypertrophy. And now, all of a sudden, apart from the hand, we saw her stomach was big on one side, the chest. The face was not yet affected. It is recent, about 2 years ago, that also we started noticing that even her face is bigger on one side.
Uwera has sought medical help for her daughter from several experts, but in vain.
We did the CT scan, we did the MRIs, we did doctors tried everything. But instead of a condition, getting better, it gets worse day by day. Recently, she started fainting. She didn't faint when she was younger. It's about like now 2 years. All of a sudden, she'll be there talking. You see the child falling down.
She has called upon Good Samaritans for financial support to raise $150,000, approximately 550 million, for travel and treatment for her daughter abroad.
For her hand, this hand is longer than this. I'm above 30, but her right hand is longer and bigger than mine. If you look at her fingernails, they are bigger and longer than mine, and it is so scary. So I'm here because I'm pleading with everyone, fellow parents. It is so hard to see your child screaming every day and you're unable to do anything.
Faith Namutebi, a school nurse, highlights Juru's condition. She explains how they have resorted to counseling to relieve Juru of pain and trauma. Dr. Joel Mirembe, a senior medical officer at Intermedical Services, describes Juru's condition. The condition is genetic and it increases the risk of developing certain childhood cancers.
But children usually need a multidisciplinary team, orthopedic team, pediatric team, vascular team, physicians, and all doctors depending on the condition. So literally the child is managed by a group, even psychologists.
Often the condition requires surgery. Unfortunately, the services are not available in Uganda. Dr. Mirembe says there is need for special programs to monitor the affected children.
Treatment is a case by case, step by step, depending on the findings. So I would want to call upon all humanitarians outside there, including government, to come to the rescue of children affected by hyperplasia, starting with Juru Banks, because for her now, she has symptoms. There are children who have this condition, but they are not having any symptoms. So they are living a normal life, but they are growing abnormally. And they also need to be monitored. Programs need to come in place to monitor these children, the cancers. These tests are expensive, by the way. So for them to be monitored, a program must be designed in government institutions such that these children are not left to suffer in silence.
Report compiled by Agnes Chotarengeriri for the news.